Hi, I'm glad that you guys are here with me, and I can't wait to start my speech anymore. Well, first of all, I have a question for you. Are you confident in yourself? I guess many of you will say yes, of course, or totally believe in yourself. Then congrats that you have a higher percent of success than many people out there. I know that not everyone is confident in themselves, and they don't believe in themselves either. So what is confidence and what is so important? Self-confidence is defined as a feeling of trust in one's abilities, qualities, and judgment. Confidence can refer to a general sense of belief and trust in one's own ability to control your life. It plays a vital role in your motivation to pursue your goals and affect how you present yourself to other people. Research had found that people who are more confident tend to be more academically successful. I'm not confident in myself, really. However, I do want to become a better version of myself, so confidence is the first step that I have to take. When you believe in yourself, you can do everything. And in this video, I want to bring you guys two tips to become more confident in yourself. The first one is stop comparing yourself to others. I'm a sophomore now, and one of the biggest problems for me used to be peer pressure. When I was in the first year, I was depressed and over there are many people who are excellent around me. A question that was always on my mind was, why can't I be like them, or why am I not as beautiful as them? However, researchers found that people who compared themselves to others experienced envy, and the more envy they experienced, the worse they felt about themselves. If you are feeling envious of someone else's life, remind yourself of your own strength and success. Your life is yours, not anyone else. Then another tip is be kind to yourself. Self-compassion involves treating yourself with kindness when you make a mistake, fail, or experience a setback. It's a way of relating to yourself, allowing you to become more emotionally flexible and enhances your connection to self and others. So the next time when you are in challenging situation, recognize that being imperfect or falling short at times is a part of living. Do your best to navigate this experience with self-compassion. Well, this may be just my personal opinion and experience, but I hope that this will be helpful for you. Thanks for listening.